This program is rated 16. Parental guidance is advised.
My name is Mary Deswater, and there's a lady on the show today. Yeah, when we were having a chat before we came here, and she has mentioned something that has been a part of my journey. You will know in a minute. Please introduce yourself.
Hello, I'm Melissa, aka Banji, and I'm happy to be here. Thanks for having me here.
Banji, what do you do?
I'm a student. I sing and I work on radio.
Radio. Yeah, it's okay. You can mention the radio station.
XFM. Yeah, XFM from 2 to 3 every day. Mm-hmm. I run the top 10 countdown. Yeah.
Yeah.
Pardon?
It's a... Olavi Omukazo Tandi Sodoro Ogude Daru.
Listen, I just got to know that Banji is a daughter of my very good friend, Banjirana, who passed away. And I actually knew her when she was younger. Her mom and her would come over to my place and we would be able to share together, pray together. Mm-hmm. Now, I was just thinking about her as I was, I'm just thinking about, you know, her mom and how, what happened to her. And lo and behold, I meet her on the set. And I'm asking, what's your name? And she says, well, I'm Banjirana. What's your first name again?
Melissa.
And I'm like, I know a Banjirana. She's like, well, which one? I said, well, the DJ was my friend. Well, that's my dad. So we're having like a big grandpa, papa meeting here.
DJ Banji.
Yeah. Oh. You're new DJ Banji. The oldie is on FM 90. That's it. That's my friend with clubs and stuff. Like, I didn't go to the clubs, but he was friends to me.
Oh my God. Yeah. And she mentioned, Banji mentioned something about working on XFM, which is a huge part of my journey. Because before it was XFM, it was 94.8 for Kampala. And guess who was on that radio? Exactly. Yeah. So XFM is where my journey started, and I am just so excited because your journey is starting there. And God knows, well, me, I sort of like took a back seat, but you don't have to. You can just fly as far as you want. Please introduce yourself. Sorry, we got caught up in the moment.
I'm a CT. Jazz bassist.
You're jazz?
Jazz bassist.
A jazz bassist. Huh. Kati munjogere nyangu le language. Kati nga, I am there watching the show with my grandmom because I always do. She's obviously going to turn to me and say, Jazz
bassist.
Yakola mulimuchi.
Asuna. Mm-hmm. First, you have to make sure. Asuna e ndongo. Na yesi ndongo. E chidongo. Chirieche.
Ogudongo.
Ogudongo. Asuna ogudongo gulyo guguba boom 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 boom.
Ah.
Guchiki bombe.
Tonyambye pasta.
Asuna ogudongo.
Ogudongo what ogudongo guli specific or is just any ndongo? Now I can explain. The best guitar. Then dum dum dum. Oh good, dong, good. Oh my God! Thank you so much for joining us on the show today. I was trying to joke, so I was not judge. Nani mga mamani show vokola na babula bisho. Hi. So guys, we just want to talk about Christmas. We just want to jazz about Christmas. Pastor Sempa, just do you? Should I call you Sempa over to Charlie?
Pastor Baba.
Baba.
Baba. Baba. Chakoba. Nangi chinkoba. I'm Pastor Gabriel Baba Gwanga Mujeri Yeso. I introduced it at the beginning of the year.
And you're sticking to it.
I'm affirming it at the end of the year.
Because I thought now that we are in December, you might, as if I've changed your
mind. No, it's going stronger. Going stronger.
Okay.
Baba after Baba.
We'll just continue. We'll just continue with that. Yeah, he said Baba after Baba. You probably don't know that Pastor Sempa influenced the party anthem, party after
party. Ah, no, chiteke kontina. I wrote the thing. Mwete munda bao. Mwete munda bao. Temwagala kunzi kiriza. People are running up to me and they say, are you Pastor Sam? I'm like, yeah. Like what? They're like, you wrote the party anthem. I'm like, okay.
Writing
can I take
it.
A selfie with you? I'm like, anytime.
Baba, listen.
Kati now you.
You're stretching this thing.
No, mubagambe ba. Je bigambo byembulira biri mwama agezi. Omwana yabifumbye nakola oluyimba lupya. Isn't it true you play the song? Kati ono no. Now, maybe you don't listen. Isn't it a hit song? Oh, chitegera.
Nero sikuona. Guys, please share your Christmas memories. Yeah?
Let me start off on Christmas. I actually think many people don't know what Christmas is.
Yes.
But it is a birthday celebration of Jesus.
The biggest celebrity the world has ever seen.
He's a son of God. So... No. Muslims also agree that Jesus was born. They don't agree that he's a son of God.
Yeah.
But it's okay. But they agree he was born. Mm-hmm. And matter of fact, they agree that he lived on earth, that he taught God's word. But there's areas where they disagree.
Okay.
So anyway, number one is Christmas is a season to celebrate the birth of a great man. And who is this great man? It's Jesus Christ. So it is a momentum. It is a day. Is it the day that he was born? Nobody really knows. And in fact, it's very unlikely he was born in December. Why? Because when he was born, the shepherds were out looking after their sheep by night. Most shepherds are not out in December, which is winter, to look after their sheep. You understand? The shepherds were out at night. So it's unlikely he was born in December. But the Christians during the Roman time, there used to be a secular celebration around 25th of a Roman god. And then the Christian says, okay, for you, if you have your hero, is such and such, for us, we will celebrate Jesus. So really, some people get confused. Kale, did Jesus get born on one? No, we will not argue about that.
Yeah, it's not.
It's not about the day. We're not fighting over the day. But what we are saying is that there was a day and a time in history where a great man was born.
2,000 years ago.
And this Jesus is, time began to be counted. From that time, we are in 2020. Why? Because we're counting when Christ was born, and we're adding, he changed the direction of history. Two, he gave us wisdom and knowledge of God. So we have way, blessed are the poor in spirit, blessed are the humble. Really, for me, I'm not in bodyguards, masape, No, I'm not in that. Because my Jesus was a humble. He says, if you want to be the leader, you must be the servant. Okay? So he changed the entire direction of leadership. Jesus not only did that, but he healed people. There was a woman with an issue of blood. Yeah. So women with issues, men got issues. Yeah. Jesus is in the business of helping people with both private and public issues.
Yeah, he did it 2,000 years ago.
He's still doing it. And if you have an issue, that Jesus we're talking about, he deals with issues.
Real
issues
so big you can't tell your best friends.
We're talking about pregnancy. There's a girl right now, a young woman who's having an issue because she's pregnant, and she doesn't know how to tell mommy or daddy. And she doesn't know because she's a dependent, and the boy is a dependent. Like for me, I made a girl pregnant.
I know.
You know about that.
I know the story.
And the boy now is grown up.
Yeah, but he has children.
At that moment, it was such a complication. Mm-hmm. But look, my mom also had me in a complication. Yeah. My dad was Indian. He's a young guy, young boy, student. My mother was a Muganda. These two were not supposed to be together. Complications, issues. So my parents' family told my mom, abort. My mother said, I am not. I'm so glad she did not. But it was an issue.
It was
serious. Right now you are saying, how am I going to go through it? How am I going to go through this complication? Jesus deals with what?
Complications.
Look, I'm here today. This last week we celebrated 20 years of Primetime Party. I've been throwing a party.
How old are you,
Mpazi? I've been throwing a party at Makerere every Saturday night for the last 20 years. Since 1999.
I've been hearing about that.
Oh, do you
want to? Yeah,
I talk about party, comedians. People have started there. Pablo. Okay. Oh, no. Mpamide. The comedian. Lexcon. Gospel artist. Many have begun there.
Yeah.
Because a platform. But then also we tell young people, save sex for marriage. Okay. Wekume. Okay, then be faithful in marriage, finish your education, leave drugs alone, blah, 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 blah. And when there are complications, we help them. So anyway, 20 years later, we were celebrating. When we counted, there's at least 1 million people whose lives can be traced back.
Linked back
to Pastor Bab. Pastor, something you did helped me. So we are celebrating 20 years. I'm glad my mom did not kill me. So as we are in this Christmas, we talk about the Jesus who helps people dealing with what?
Complication.
Yeah, so I'm going to take a break and then maybe my sister can also say, if you're depressed.
First, wait.
Yeah.
Who calls for a break on this show?
A break. You all know I'm a TV host also. What you might want to wait a minute? I just think we're TV CEO. Chiri Musai. TV. I mean, there are things you just go. You are born to do it.
But I like it when you're here because I do like half the work.
I was born for this.
Guys, we'll be back.